This is part one on an introduction to percents and the meaning of percent, and also how to write a percent as a fraction and how to write a percent as a decimal. And we do the following six problems on this video. We're going to talk about the meaning of percent and then learn how to write percents as fractions or decimals. So the percent symbol here looks like this symbol in red here. So if I were to write 42%, that's what it would look like. So this is, you read this as 42%. Now, what does that mean? What does that mean, 42%? Well, let's look at that word percent and break it up. Per cent. What does cent mean? Usually it's 100. So you could think of this as per 100 of something, which can be also thought of as out of 100. So when you read 42%, you could think of this as 42 out of 100. So let's look at it that way. 42% means 42 out of 100. And when I say that, the out of 100 could be thought of as just a division. So 42% really means 42 divided by 100. So the key thing is a percent sign really can be always replaced with just divided by 100. Now, once we've written this 42% as 42 divided by 100, our next step will be how could we simplify that? How could we write it as a fraction, or how could we write it as a decimal? And that's what we'll be going over in the rest of this video. So we're going to use the meaning of percent to rewrite that little percent symbol. What it really means is divide by 100. So we can take 30% and rewrite it as 30. Now, the percent symbol right here, in yellow, really means divided by 100. So instead, I'm going to write, instead of the percent symbol, divided by 100. That's what it means. 30% means 30 divided by 100. Now, there's different ways you could simplify 30 divided by 100. Okay? One is, one meaning of dividing by 100 is just write 30 over 100. So if I were going to write this as a fraction, I could simply write it as 30 over 100 and then reduce it, which dividing the top and bottom by 10, that gives me 3/10. So that is how to write 30% as a fraction. All right? So 30% of the fraction is just written 3/10. Now another way to do 30 divided by 100, anytime you divide something by 100, you get to move the decimal two places to the left. Now 30, you don't see a decimal place, a decimal point. So that means it's here at the end, and if you move it to the left two, then the decimal point would be in front of the three. So if I were going to write this as a decimal, I just move it two to the left, and that's how to write 30% as a decimal. Now you could write 0.30, but usually if you have zeros at the end after, the decimal point, you leave those off. So 0.3. So both of these are ways of writing the number 30%. So let's try another one. So first, let's write 26% as a decimal. Again, remember that percent sign means divide by 100. So I take the 26, and in place of the percent, all I have to do is write divide by 100. And when you divide by 100, you move the decimal two to the left. So the decimal, which you don't really see, is at the end of the number here. And if I move it two to the left, it'll be in front of the two. So this is really 0.26. So that's how you would write it as a decimal. have the decimal point, 2/6. Now, the way this reads, by the way, is 26 hundredths. Okay, that's how you would read this number correctly. Now, what if I wanted to write 26% as a fraction? All right, well, we do the same thing. What does this mean? It means 26%. It means 26 divided by 100, which is just 26 over 100. And then that reduces to what? You could divide the top and bottom by 2, so that's 13/50. So that's how to write 26% as a fraction. Now remember up here when I said 26 divided by 100 is 0.26, you could read that as 26 hundredths. Well, of course, there you see it, 26 hundredths. So a roundabout way of doing this is first write it as a decimal and then rewrite your decimal as a fraction. You could do that too, or you could just go directly. Now, some people do shortcuts here. To write 26% as a decimal, they know when you divide by 100, you're just going to move the decimal 2 to the left, and so you might be able to go directly to this. You just move the decimal to the left, and you're dropping the percent sign, right? So when you divide by 100, you don't write that percent sign anymore, and so you can certainly just go directly to 0.26. Same thing for writing 26% as a fraction. Instead of first writing 26 divided by 100, you could simply right away just put the 26 over 100. So some people will go directly to this step. So let's try a couple where we can go directly to that step. But just remember, I'm just writing out the meaning here first. It does mean 26 divided by 100, and there's more than one way of writing 26 divided by 100. So here's another problem. Write 32% as a, all right, we're going to do it as a decimal, and then we're going to do it as a fraction. So what's the easy way to change 32% to a decimal? We just move the decimal point 2 to the left. That means you won't have the percent sign anymore. So our answer is 0.32. So that's the shortcut. And what about as a fraction? 32%, again, means 32 divided by 100. So if you want, you could just write 32 divided by 100 in fractional form, and then you need to reduce that fraction. So let's see. You could divide both the numerator and denominator by 4, right? And so that's going to give you 8/25. So there's three ways of writing the same number. You've got 32%, which is the same thing as 0.32, which is the same thing as 8/25. They all mean the same thing. One is written in percent form, one is written in decimal form, and one is written as a fraction. All right, here's some problems for you to try. So put the video on pause and try these three problems. Now, when you're writing as a fraction, that could end up being a whole number, or it could be a fraction that you need to reduce. Okay, you back with me? All right, let's do this. 17%. How do we write that as a decimal? Well, that's 17 divided by 100, so we move the decimal 2 to the left, and you should have 0.17. So let's just write each one as a decimal first. 6%. Move the decimal 2 to the left. So you have to leave that space for the 0, and that's 0.06. 200%. You're going to move that 2 to the left. That just gives you the number 2. So that's a whole number. Doesn't look like a decimal, but you could write it as 2.0 for instance. So it's a decimal number, basically. It's not a fraction. All right, so now let's write each of these as fractions, going from the percent. So 17% means 17 over 100, so we just write 17 over 100. How about 6%? That means 6 over 100. Is that reduced? Nope. You've got to divide the numerator and denominator by 2, so that'll give you 3/50. And how about this last one? Well, you can't do anything with 2. That's as simplified as you can get. So 2 would be the answer whether you're writing it as a decimal or as a fraction. For these other ones, 6%, that's how we 0.06 is how you would write it in decimal form, 3/50ths in fraction form, 17%, 0.17, or 17 hundredths. So this is basically an introduction, how to write a percent as a decimal or a fraction. It can get quite a bit more complicated depending if the number you're given in percent, it has a decimal point in it already, or if it has a fraction in it already. So we're just doing the basics here, and then you want to go on to my video. The next video, we're going to work on just changing something in percent form to decimals, and then we'll do another video where we're just changing percent forms to fractions.